What sentence should then be imposed for the offence of murder and for the false swearing charges? In relation to the murder, the Crown and Mr. Chappell have each relied on a body of material demonstrating the range of sentencing for killings committed by parents and others of children in the years between 1994 and 2001. It is accepted by the Crown that sentencing practices have moved adversely to the offender since 2001, particularly as a consequence of the introduction of the standard non-parole period regimes. That being the case, I am required to sentence Miss Lane in accordance with the sentencing practices as at the date of the commission of the offence. The material placed before me emerges from Chapter 5 of a research document entitled Sentenced Homicides in New South Wales, 1994 to 2001, published by the Judicial Commission of New South Wales. 22 of the 73 child killers examined in that survey were sentenced for murder. However, only 10 of them were parents or partners of parents of the victims. Indeed, in the catalogue, in the entire catalogue of these murders, there was only one mother who was sentenced for the murder of her child. This particular crime, according to the sentencing judge, was in the worst possible category for such an offence. It involved, apparently, the brutal and continuous bashing and killing of a six-year-old child by the mother and her partner. Consequently, it is of little or no assistance in the present case. By comparison, there were 12 mothers of victims who were convicted of manslaughter or infanticide. Once again, because of the different crimes involved, however, those sentences are of no assistance in the present matter. The result of the analysis is, as the Crown has submitted, that the available body of relevant cases is simply too small. There is insufficient statistical material capable of putting the necessary practical flesh upon the theoretical bones so as to assist the court to any great degree in sentencing the offender in relation to the murder charge. I note in passing, although it is not significantly relevant, that in the case of the 22 child killers who were sentenced for murder in the relevant period, the median sentence was 19 years and 6 months, with a non-parole period of 14 years and 6 months. But as I have said, only 10 of these were parents or partners, and only one was in the category of a mother. I have earlier set out some material that's been provided to me showing the sentencing pattern for false swearing charges, so there's no need for me to repeat those details here. For the murder charge, it falls to the court, in the absence of a helpful sentencing pattern, to reflect upon the objective seriousness of the offence, as I have identified it, and to ensure in imposing a sentence that it is proportional to the criminality involved. In achieving the necessary synthesis, it is necessary, of course, that I take into account as well the subjective features of the offender, as well as all other matters that are relevant to sentencing, as required by the legislation. Miss Lane's been in custody now since the 13th of December 2010. I will direct that her sentence, save for any degree of accumulation, be backdated, so as to operate from that date. Miss Lane, I'd ask you now to stand, please. Keli Lane, for the offence of false swearing committed on the 3rd of April 1995, I sentence you to a fixed term of imprisonment of 9 months, such sentence to date from the 13th of December 2010 and to expire on the 12th of September 2011. For the offence of false swearing committed on or about the 29th of April 1995, I sentence you to a fixed term of imprisonment of 9 months, such sentence to date from the 13th of December 2010 and to expire on the 12th of September 2011. For the offence of false swearing committed on or about the 13th of September 1999, I sentence you to a fixed term of imprisonment for 12 months, such sentence to date from the 13th of February 2011 and to expire on the 12th of February 2012. Keli Lane, for the murder of your daughter Tegan, I sentence you to a non-parole period of 13 years and 5 months, to date from the 13th of December 2010 and to expire on the 12th of May 2023, with a balance of term of 4 years and 7 months. The balance of term is to commence on the 13th of December 2004 and is to expire on the 12th of December 2028. Ms. Lane, I should explain to you then that the overall sentence for the murder charge is imprisonment for a term of 18 years. You are to serve a non-parole period. The term of the non-parole period is such that you must serve 13 years and 5 months in prison before becoming eligible for parole. I've backdated your sentence to the date you went into custody. You will be eligible to be released on parole on the 12th of May 2023. Thank you, Macy. Before I adjourn, may I remind the media of the suppression orders in relation to the names of Ms. Lane's daughter and the fathers of her two adopted children. Is there any other matter, Mr. Crown? Mr. Chappell? The court will now adjourn.